As of May 25th of 2025, there are currently 46 volcanoes which are actively erupting around the planet, the same number as were erupting last week, albeit with two changes. One of these erupting volcanoes is Ethiopia's Erta Ale volcano, a massive shield volcano located in the Afar Depression, which interestingly starts its edifice below sea level. Erta Ale has been continuously erupting since 1967, repeatedly filling and then overflowing one or both of its summit lava lakes. And now, here are this week's top volcano-related news stories. In Vanuatu, increasing uplift is seemingly occurring at the nation's Ambae volcano, meaning its summit could soon be the site of its first eruption in 11 months. Meanwhile, in Indonesia, the strongest earthquake storm to occur since the Banda Api volcano last erupted in 1988 struck. And, in what is this week's top story, a little-known United States volcano had its height recently increased by 95 feet or 29 meters, and as a result, it is now so much closer to forming a brand new volcanic island. What I am referring to is the remote Ayi Seamount volcano located in the northern Mariana Islands, specifically 365 miles or 587 kilometers north of the populated island of Saipan. Currently, this basaltic andesite stratovolcano rises a whopping 3,000 meters or 9,843 feet above the surrounding ocean floor. That means Ayi has a higher prominence than California's towering Mount Shasta volcano does, just to give you an idea of how massive this submarine volcano is. This week's news comes due to a new revelation that Ayi no longer has a summit depth of 79 meters or 259 feet below sea level, as last measured in 2018. Due to near continuous eruptions since November 2022 that have frequently discolored overlying ocean water, its summit through lava fusion as measured on May 19, 2025 is now only 50 meters or 164 feet below sea level. That is an impressive rate of growth across around 18 and a half months of eruptive activity since there have been some pauses in between recent eruptions. This suggests that under the very best of circumstances, the Ayi Seamount, if it was to begin erupting again today and continuously erupt lava non-stop from a brand new volcanic island on January 22, 2028. So, should we all mark our future calendars awaiting this possibility? In my opinion, probably not, as what I just described is still quite unlikely, requiring a perfect set of circumstances. Also, two problems. Number one, volcanoes get rather explosive at very shallow depths underwater, creating what are known as Tsersayan eruptions. Ayi Seamount hasn't seemingly reached this stage quite yet, but if it did, it would be quite likely to destroy the top few feet of its edifice every time an explosion occurs, so it might take a lot longer than you think to reach the surface. Point 2. Ayi Seamount's summit has both risen and fallen in recent times due to eruptive activity, so growing in height is not a guarantee. For example, an eruption in 2014 caused its summit to drop from 197 feet to 246 feet below sea level. Thus, while it is fully possible that Ayi Seamount could reach the surface sometime this century, that scenario is far from a certainty. Meanwhile, in Vanuatu, the Ambae shield volcano is showing some signs of life, as, since the beginning of April, it appears that its central cone has been uplifted by around 7 centimeters or 2.8 inches. In my opinion/analysis, this is most likely occurring due to the rise or pulling of underground basaltic magma, meaning that this vent could erupt sometime in the next 2 months. Such an eruption, if it were to occur, would likely be moderately explosive with Tsersayan explosions and ash emissions. And, in Indonesia, May 23rd saw the Banda Api volcano produce its strongest earthquake storm in 37 years. As, while normally, this island stratovolcano, which is in close proximity to 20,000 people, produces between 2 and 6 earthquakes a day, yet, on Friday, this figure rose to slightly more than 100 earthquakes. This marks the third notable earthquake swarm in the last year, suggesting that something is different compared to prior years. Yet, since earthquakes thereafter declined, its alert level was kept at yellow. And now, here is a quick list of all the world's volcanoes which are currently erupting. Additionally, here are some volcanoes showing signs of unrest which are not erupting as of the recording of this video on May 24th of 2025. As a final note, I would like to thank my new YouTube channel member Scott Stewart for supporting my work.